So we'll open the floor na to our guests and to our media friends from the media and bloggers. If you have any questions.
First of all, congratulations to the international film year at Tokyo. Can you share some like feedback or comments of the audience after seeing the film in the Tokyo?
Tokyo is great because we go back to, you know, the land where they create a lot of these kind of crazy supernatural kind of creatures in the film. So they have a long history of cinema with very strange things happening. So, but the audience reaction in Tokyo is great because Japanese people are very peculiar in expressing their, they don't really show much emotion, right? So some people watch the film trying to keep a straight face while not being scared in the scary moments, trying to be very Japanese. So it was quite funny seeing them kind of fidget a little bit, breaking their Japanese-ness.
To the director, is there like a conscious effort that the Filipino audience could be able to relate on this film, or you did it with your own vision, like that everyone can relate on this film?
I think for me, in terms of relatability, it's really about children trying to become their own people, stepping out their parents' shoes.
In everyday lives, we are faced with that same choice that we should make. So, yeah, it's maybe magnified lang in a bigger setting. But.
So, how did you start visualizing or doing this film?
Well, my first film is a very straightforward kind of art house drama with the late Pepe Smith. And it was very, you know, it's a very small film, it's a very intimate film. And we wanted to try something totally different this time for the second film. So with my producer, Bianca, who also co-wrote the film, we decided, like, let's go crazy as we can, as different as we can. So we came up with the idea, let's go with, let's try something supernatural, let's try something with a horror element to it.
This is a little hard to actually do, since you have, like, an international cast. How did that come about? How did you, like, together people from different countries?
I think the idea is like all these relationships were created through the international circuit, and then it's kind of like we should really work together. And then it's always a joke when you say that, let's work together, because how would you fit this in, you know, how would these guys come in? But then when there's a project that's international like this with a subject matter about immigration, about how these kind of immigrants from our part of the world, Southeast Asia, end up in this mystical Western land where they think it's the best place to be, and then suddenly they need to escape from this place. So I think
you and this Aga, I don't know if that's like a shot in the arm that you told in previous interviews, that you know, this film is also about humans actually getting desensitized about deaths or murders per se. Do you think it mirrors what governments are doing? Certain governments, I'm not saying this is the government, are doing with their people?
I think these times we are presented with very, very distinct problems because of immigration, people crossing borders, diba? And I think also there's a certain, if you cross borders, then you bring in also a certain kind of culture, and some people cannot really relate to that. And then there is discord. This, you know, you, it's so hard to like come together because of different views in certain things. It's weird now, we're open, but we're actually closed at the same time.
To Ms. Agat, what was it like working with the film's international cast?
Everyone just brought their A game in the movie, and we saw Bradley's vision of the film, and we stayed in Makati for like 2 weeks. We see each other every day, day in, day out.
Some
and
for,
oh yeah, some stayed for two months, right? And then we went to Slovenia all together. So it was interesting the way the process is different from Jan's process, especially the Belgian actor's process is different. He's really so much into it, word per word. And I think the Asian actors, the Southeast Asian actors, are more really feeling instinct, gut. I mean, that's how they we worked as Asians. So, you know, it's interesting. You kind of learn from all of them at the same time. But we have fun. I mean, they're crazy people, just like us.
Okay, we keep saying that it's a different cut from what was shown previously. What do you think is? How can you explain to the people like kung ano yung iba dito sa cut na inalabas natin?
I think it's great because usually when you do a director's cut or something, or you do like a commercial cut, people kind of trim off minutes. But I actually added almost 5 minutes of footage into this film. A lot more creepy scenes, a lot more character moments, and the beauty of it is we also did another full sound design pass with our French sound designer. So I think it's really, really special because like our music composer we met in a festival in Australia. So our music composer is South African, so everything you hear in all the music scoring in the film is someone from South Africa doing it off-site. And then the sound designer is a great collaborator who's French, who's based in Cambodia right now. So everything, it's kind of like this, the film travels even in the post-production process to kind of get back to the Philippines again. So it's all new sound as well.
Anyone? Any questions?
Miss Agot, pahabo lang po. How's working with JC?
Have I worked with JC before this? Can't remember. I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think so. JC, he's so focused, like obsessively focused. And Brad didn't want him to eat because he needed to be very, very skinny for the role. Because it was, you know, starving. It has to be at a time where food is scarce, and you know, so, and he wasn't eating. So he's so, so dedicated and so focused, and he would show up 100%, 110%, he's there.
Last direct, so far, how's working with Black Sheep?
It's fantastic. Black Sheep, it's really wonderful because they came in with the majority of the finance. I mean, this film's an international co-production, so the way we finance, the financing structure comes from a lot of parties internationally, from Taiwan, from Thailand, from Singapore, from Slovenia. But the majority, and I'm very happy to say, the majority of the financing structure comes from the Philippines ourselves. So Black Sheep, thank you very much for that part. And also, it's wonderful because the amount of creative freedom Black Sheep gave me is they didn't say no to anything. Yeah, just the trust is great. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Director Bradley and Ms. A.
Hi, Sheepmates. I'm JC Santos, and I'm inviting you to check in on all the fun Black Sheep has in store for you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the bell button.